design, beam, design, or steel, beam, design. So we cover tension members, we find them in truss members or cables, then compression members, we find them in trusses also, columns and buildings, and arches, and now beam. Okay, the most famous structural element, beams. Okay, you can find it's a girder or a beam or a flat beam. The general name is beam, and yani beam is a general. If you say girder, usually you are talking about big beam. If you say in bridges, the beam in bridges, the big beam we call it stringer, stringers. There are big beams in bridges, when you saw the big beam, they call it stringer. Usually when you say a girder, it's a beam carrying a beam. Yeah, and there's something called floor beam. It's the first beam that's carrying the slab. Over beam carrying the slab. They call it floor beam. The beam that's carrying this beam, the hammer beam, is usually called a girder. But all are beams. And the definition of a beam, the beam, is a structural member that's loaded perpendicular to its major axis. The axial load is almost zero or ignored. And the axial load, ignored. If we have axial load in the beam, it becomes a frame element or a beam column, which is the subject of what's coming. Yani the column, the column now, the beam combined together, it's a beam column. Remember, called beam column. Good? So this is typically beams. So this one we are looking for. Remember the tension member? What's the ultimate strength or the design strength? Phi Pn, which is phi Tn for tension members. Ultimate tensile strength. For compression members, phi Cn. Ultimate compressive strength of the member. Pure compression, pure tension. Now what we are looking for here in beams? Phi Mn. The nominal capacity, the nominal bending capacity times a phi factor gives us the design bending moment. The design moment capacity. The ultimate moment capacity. The word nominal, when you use it, that's the maximum. That's what you get from the lab. This is called nominal in the LRFD. If you multiply it by a phi factor, the phi factor you get, the design strength. In beams, the forces are shear and bending. So the beam now, the steel beam, must be checked against, as we check, bending from ultimate front loads and V ultimate front loads. V shear usually is always checked. And the steel members, you will see, they are good. The last lecture, there's one lecture on the shear strength. But the most important thing is the bending capacity. The bending capacity. It's different than concrete. Better than concrete. Why? Because of the steel is it's a very good material. It's elastoplastic material. There is no cracking. There is no cracking. It's elastoplastic material. Good? There is buckling. There is buckling. Why? Because we have positive moment in a single supported beam. Positive moment. So there's one side in tension, one side in compression, right? Like this cantilever. Does it have positive moment or negative moment?
Positive.
Negative moment. Cantilever have a negative moment. So it's fixed here. So there's a negative moment. Negative moment, what does it mean? شو معنى? Compression at the bottom, tension at the top. Now you're saying this is steel, who cares? And reinforced concrete, it's important, so the reinforcement is at the top. الحديد فوق. Now this is steel, who cares? Exactly. Look at the section. This section, I section or the Y flange section, it has a top flange, a whip, and a bottom flange. So the top flange now will be in compression. The whip, part of it in compression, part of it in tension above the neutral axis.
And
tension. Is there any problem in tension? يعني شيكنا ايش called slenderness in the tension member? Nothing. Did we check slenderness? يعني is it important was a recommendation but high recommendation. يعني L over R was allowed to be 300. 300 is so high. And remember, 40 feet, that's so long. Really. It's just like they don't want you to exceed that limit. تمام? So usually there's no problem. about buckling, flexural buckling, flexural torsional buckling. No problem. Whip, again, part of it in tension, part of it in compression. How about the bottom one? It's in compression. So that's when you have some limitation on the bottom flange. The bottom flange. Okay? So some of the components might be in compression, need to be checked. Now this is the issue. Listen. The bottom flange wants to buckle because it's in compression. Where is the compression coming from? What sort? From bending. The compression is coming from bending. So what's the compression from bending? It's a compressive stress, right? Sigma x. You remember when I draw things for you here? So there is sigma x due to bending. Bending in a cross section. It causes tension here if it's like this. Tension, compression here over the neutral axis. So this is tension and this is compression. If it's like this, tension and compression. It could be the other way. The compressive stress, if you multiply it by the area, it gives you a resultant. See, big compression force. Yeah, the stress, integration of the stress times the area gives you force. And this one gives you big T. This is tensile and this is compression. Give you big T. Both of those are equal to satisfy the equilibrium. Sum of the force and divide in the x direction equal to zero. T equals C. Both of those, they are opposite. What does this give you? Coupled moment. Coupled moment resisting this moment or due to this moment. So T times the distance between them give you M. Opposite to M. Good? So due to this compressive stress, this flange here or this part or some of it is in compression. So usually it may buckle. It depends on the end braced sub length of the beam. Forget it, LB, later on, LB. But what's happening, this compression flange is attached to the web. So the web provides lateral stiffness against buckling of the compression flange. Not only that, there is a tension flange, the tension is also catching them, mosquito. So beams usually they don't buckle like the buckling of the column. Some in compression, some in tension, they buckle in a way it's called torsional, lateral torsional buckling. Lateral torsional buckling. Why? Because there is a tension flange that is providing a stiffness to the compression flange. This is what you will see in the movie. Here. Beam global buckling. So this is the beam. So this is positive moment. Compression at the top, tension at the bottom. This is with the web. Only web and the compression flange. This is how they buckle. This way. Then you have a tension flange. So this is same. When you have the tension plan, now let's talk about something. This and this, lateral torsional buckling. So we are looking for the ultimate moment capacity. If the unsupported leg exceeds this leg, it goes down. If it exceeds this one, it is so small. If you have the unsupported leg less than LE, the member will develop the full material strength. The full material strength. If the unsupported leg is big, you have a reduction in the moment. See how is the concept? This is lateral torsional. Lateral to the side and twist. Okay. It's in the elastic. happens in the plastic or inelastic region. This is elastic, this is inelastic. Elastic, inelastic. Remember this slender. How is the region slender? This is the unsupported length. Unsupported length of the compression. Flange is so long. But as we go, we'll explain this concept. First, I'm going to show you the concept. But this is the general idea. We're trying to develop the full capacity of the beam. What's the full capacity of the beam? Okay, for compression member, for the column, what's the maximum strength you can get for a column? Pure axial loading, 0.9, A gross, Fy. Right? 0.9, A gross, Fy. Any section that is KL over R is very small, will give you this full capacity. If KL over R starts increasing, exceeding some limits, then you have a reduction. Then we calculated FCR, which is smaller than FY. We have know how to calculate all of that, right? This is due to flexural buckling. Then we make sure the local buckling is not an issue. If local buckling is an issue, we know how to take care of it. Good. Now, here is the same concept. We're trying to develop the full capacity of the beam. What's the full capacity? Phi M N. The design moment capacity of the beam. Now bending, the design moment capacity of the beam. So if someone's asking you, so what's the design bending capacity of the beam? So what's the bending stress? Tell him, okay, sigma equal my over I. The maximum is mc over I. If it's symmetric, c top and c bottom will be the same, right? If you have an edge, a rectangular section with edge, the depth is edge, c is how much? H over 2. If the width, the width is B, what's I? BH cubed over 12, right? Right? For a rectangular section, what's the moment of inertia? BH cubed over 12. Can you open here? Bending stress, sigma, equal M, Y over I. The maximum, MC over I. Right? This is mechanics. Bending stress equal MC over I. This is plus minus. One sided tension, one sided component. If you have a rectangular section, this is B and this is H. What's I? BHU over 12. What's C? That's your C. C equal H over 2. Put this one, H over 2. Sorry. Look, so sigma equal M over I over C. Then I over C. Right? I over C is what? S. What's S? Section modulus. What's S? Is the section modulus. Yeah, a section modulus for the structural steel shapes is given like the area. Yeah, and the manual is giving you S for any shape. So in the design, if you know what's the material strength, if we are doing A992, you know Fy, right? You know what's Fy? It is 50 KSI for A992, right? For A36, it's 36 KSI. So we know what's Fy. And this one we get from the structural analysis. You know what's some alternate? From the dead load and live load. You magnify the load and you calculate the moment. If it's simply supported, W square over 12. If it's more defined than simply supported, you calculate it. So we have this one. And we have this one from the material we use. So what do we design for? S. In the design, we select S more than what you need. The first S greater than what you need. Like the area for the tension member. This is area required. Go select something, the first one, with area greater than this. Good? So this is the section modulus. I remember. So I'm saying S equal M over sigma. Wait. If sigma is F1, right? If sigma is F1, this is S for the material still elastic. This is the upper elastic limit. Fy is the upper elastic limit. If the material is elastoplastic, this is still proportional. This is the yield based on that. This M we call it M1. Good? This is the fixed moment that will cause yielding in the steel. So if you multiply Fy times S, usually S, what S? About the scrolling axis, the beam will align about to give you high, high. And if you don't use this, if this was the beam, you don't use it this way. It will deflect too much. You use it this way so that you increase. Yeah, if you use it this way, this is your B and this is your H. H is small. When you do H cube, it will give you a small I. If you do this, this is your B and this is your H. H cube will give you higher I. So you align it about the strong axis. Ix. So this is Sx. And this is Ix about the strong axis. Good? Good. It's on the. Always we have in the manual that they give you the information. Y up and X horizontal, right? So I about the strong axis. So this is Sx. So My, the yield moment, is Fy times Sx. Now remember, in beams it's different, guys. In beams, if restrain. What does it mean? That location changed to
solids. The full location here become, but I remember this is over the cross section, and the neighbors the same thing. And this one will start yielding, and this one will start yielding till this full one, full region become plastic. This is what they call it, plastic hinge formation. This become hinge. This become hinge, internal hinge. Then there is a failure. Good? Good? This become plastic hinge. Remember, this is this location here, it takes moment. Once all the cross section yields, it means this is like a hinge. It doesn't take any moment. It will rotate, so the section will fail. That's failure. Remember, this one is different than, so M Y equal what? S F Y. This case is different. What's this stress here? F Y. What's this one here? It's a H over 2. So what's the moment strength? This F Y.
Cross section and
last second. You get it here. The full section developed, the full cross-section developed, F1. The section is plastic. So the plastic moment is the result of that stress. Z times F1. Good? So something called shape factor. Z over S. Shape factor, by definition, it's Z over S. Good? Or MP over M1. See? MP equals ZF1. MY equals SFY. So the shape factor is the shape. And how the shape will fail if the full cross section is yielding or developed last second. So either Z over S or MP over M1. That's when someone's telling sketch the stress condition for unplastic. Yes. Stress the stress condition, sketch the stress condition for MY. This is your case. Good. So this is what's happening. See, yielding going from the top all the way and to the neighbors. Why this one start yielding too? Because the moment is increasing here. Plastic end. Usually this location it means usually tell us over a length. Quarter of the span or one third of the span. And a third of the span or one third of the span. Okay. Example. This is the rectangle. This is the rectangle. I equal so S equal B square over 6. This is D. It's calling the full section is D, or you can call it H. So S we know B square over 6. So the MY, if you calculate it, this is what we get. Fy vd square over 6. Yeah, full rectangular section. Full, solid. It's not the HSS. HSS will have a thickness, then from inside is empty or hollow. Good. That's MY. This is MY. Fy vd square over 6. For this rectangle, if you calculate what's on Z, exactly what I said. Yes. So this, you will find Z equal Vd square over 4. So the shape factor will be Vd square over 4 over Vd square over 6. It's 1.5 for a rectangular section. The shape factor is 1. So if you know S for rectangular section, which is Vd square over 4 or Vx square over, sorry, Vd square over 6 or Vx square over 6, what's Z? 1.5 times that number. Or someone's going to derive it. Straightforward. This is how you do it. This is the areas. Calculate Z for this. Then calculate S, which you know. Then Z over S gives you the shape factor. The shape factor. Good? Example. Determine the yield moment MY, the plastic or nominal moment MB, and the plastic modulus Z for the simply supported beam. Having the cross section shown, also calculate the shape factor and nominal load Vn acting transverse through the midspan of the beam, assume Fy equal to 6. So he's asking you calculate Mz and My, and after that, what's Vn? That will cause failure. Vn, L over 4 equal Mn, if you calculate Vn. And this is a simple equation. Remember this? This is just to remind you with the hard calculate find the centroid. Then calculate the moment of inertia. You know how to calculate the centroid for this?
Yes.
Okay. You go from one side. You want to calculate the centroid from top or bottom? Depends. You want to calculate from top or bottom? You want to calculate from top? You will calculate y bar where? Whatever. From top. So each component, the area of each component times the distance between that component to your reference axis. Sum of AI, YI, divided by sum of AI. So, 15 times 1 times 1.5. Plus, 15 times 1 times 8.5. The distance from the centroid with this one to the top. 1 and 7.5. 1 plus 7.5, 8.5. Plus, 8 times 1 times 16.5. Distance from here all the way statics, the last chapter of statics. Statics, the one we have. So that's Y bar. This is Y bar for the composite section. Now this is composite from this rectangular piece, from this rectangular piece, and from this rectangular piece, right? Now what's I? You use the parallel axis theorem. It's the moment of inertia of each component about its centroidal axis, plus the area of that component times the square of the distance between the centroid of that component and the centroid of that composite axis. Yeah, for this one, pH cube over 12. 15, 1 تكعيب 12. زائد الاريا 15 في 1 times ضرب المسافة من هون the centroidal axis square. 15 times 1 cube over 12 plus 15 times 1 times y bar minus this distance here square. The parallel axis theorem. So if you do this one, we calculated the centroid from the top, I think. Or now we calculate from bottom. 9.974. Once you have it, you can find I for the composite section. So that's all I, 1672 inch to the 4. So what's S now? There's two S's, remember. There's S to the top and there's S to the bottom. There's S to the top, S to the bottom. S top is I doesn't change. I divided by the distance from here to here. That's S top. Now what's S bottom? I divided by the distance from here to here. This is your C now. And this is your C. It's I over C. Right? So now why there's S top or S bottom? Because there is sigma is plus minus. There is tension and there is compression. So if you are interested, so this one, what is the tension? What is the compression? Tension at the bottom. So if the question is calculate the tensile, you use S bottom. If you are interested in the compressive, you use S top. If you are interested in the maximum, you use the maximum, the highest, the largest, mainly the stress and C. So the larger the C, the higher the stress. كل ما زادت C, كل ما زادت stress. Okay? So, كل ما زادت C, كل ما قلت S. يعني the smaller the S, the higher the stress. كل ما قلت S, كل ما زادت stress.
كيف تحسب Z؟
ها؟
Z.
Z؟ S بحكي لك. معقد صح؟ You know how to calculate S? So the stress, so the moment is F y times S. Remember, this is all in kip. If you do this in inch, so you divide by 12 to get it in kip foot. Yeah, this result here, high, this time, this is kip inch. Usually, we deal with kip foot in bending. And kip inch is a huge number. I'm coming here. So you divide by 12 to change it to kip foot. If this one wasn't bound, inch, to change to kip foot, you divide by 12,000. If it was in kip foot, you want to change it to pound inch, you multiply by 12,000.
Kilo pound.
Yeah, 12,000 and 12. Thank you. جماعه هي هاي بي اتش كيو اوفر 12 زائد بي اتش بالديستنس سكوير اجمعهم واطرحها. If the parallel axis at the edge and at the edge it's بي اتش كيو اوفر 3. تعرف الشهاده ترجع استدعي او هيك تعلمت. Equal MP. MP equal PNL over machine تعطيك 158.3 once the machine give you that number you have failure. You have failure due to elastic hinge formation. Elastic hinge formation will be lateral torsion happening in the beam. Good? So that's the concept of. Let's go back here. What is the plastic? Plastic moment. The plastic moment is defined as the ratio of the plastic moment, we know this, right? To the yield stress, yani MP over FY you're using. It can be defined as the first moment of area, the first moment of area above the neutral axis when the area is above and below the neutral axis are equal. The first moment of area. So what's the first moment of area of this?
The area comes.
The first moment of area. Is the first moment of area, yani is the moment of inertia nafsa? So what's the moment of inertia? The second moment of area is the moment of inertia. Yani, the moment of inertia is the first moment of the first moment of area. The green integration of y squared dA, right? The first moment of area is integration of y dA. The second moment of inertia, second moment of area is the moment of inertia. Yeah, second moment here, first moment of the first moment. First of first, but should first moment of area for this one? Area times the distance from the centroid about your reference axis. Yeah, what is this one? 8. 8 times 1, that's the area. What's its first moment about your reference axis? Times? Plus 11 times 1 times 5.5 plus 15 times 1 times 4.5 plus this the 4 the 15 minus 11 is 4 times 1 times 2 the first moment of area where about where about an axis that have the areas above and below are equal. Good. So that's the new definition for you. It's a new definition. Last, why, what's the concept? How much time we have? 2 minutes? What's up? Now, listen. Nerja, remember this figure before?
Yes.
So, the section is so slender. Any section. It will fail before any piece or any location have any yield stress. Come on, let's say yielding any mechanism. Those sections, whether it's column or beam or whatever we call it, slender. If the section develop FY at some location, give you FY, and then fail after that, we call it non-compact. We said non-compact section is good for columns.
Not good for beams.
Not good for why? Because I want the beam to develop. Elastic hinge. So I want the beam not only to develop a FY, but to sustain it for some time. يتحمل على فترة. And the full section develop. That's the concept. Yeah, this is sustaining FY such that the full section اللي تحتيه صار FY. The full section is best. It's really developed Z for me. And حصلت Z. So that the moment I designed for is MP. When we design the beam, we design it for MP. If the section تبعك بدوش تحمل MP, finish. You cannot use it. Right? So what do we call this from here to here? Or we see something like this. What do we call it? What's this behavior?
Ductility.
Ductile behavior. What's the definition of ductility index? Ductility index. Displacement or strain at ultimate divided by strain or displacement at yield. And this is energy, by the way, this is energy. But when you have it under stress strain, it stiffens. Do you understand this one? What's the definition of toughness? What's the toughness? يعني شوف لو كانت هاي load و displacement الاريا تبعهم load و displacement لو كانت stress and strain الاريا تبعهم is stress times strain load P times delta gives you energy, right? Right? Gives you energy و stress times epsilon energy. Toughness is energy. Energy slash يعني per unit volume. طلع مع سلها. مش عندنا البي ودلتا. كيف بتطلع ستريس من البي؟ تقسم على ايه؟ كيف بتطلع سترين من ال؟ تضرب على ال. صار هذا سترين وصار هذا ستريس. هذا ايش يا جماعه؟ الانرجي بير فوليوم از تفنس. نشوفكم ان شاء الله الخميس.